to defeat the course like rock climber Christopher Geis, who climbed the mountain in 103.60 seconds. Sean O'Brien, a personal trainer from Washington, D.C., who stumbled early on, but still managed to whip the course into shape at 111.68.
Platt, the second of three Platt brothers to be sent home. So, there's a new man on the bubble.
That's Sean O'Brien. He's now the guy who has to sweat it out. The time to beat is 111.68.
He might not be on the bubble long, because next up is Dorian Cedars. He was in our top 30 last year.
He was coming off a torn bicep. It kept him out of the semifinals last year. Now, let's see if he's totally healed.
Real interesting, starting off with an angled approach. He has a lot of muscle. He's kind of a bigger guy for this course. So he's just not as light on his feet as a lot of the competitors.
Yeah, he got through the bridge of blades fairly nimbly. Let's see how he does on the spider jump.
This guy was a national champion cheerleader at the University of Colorado. He wants to prove that cheerleaders are athletes too.
Got through relatively easily and didn't expend a lot of energy. Great for a guy his size.
The building is great to have a lot of muscle for events like this, but man, those muscles fatigue quickly. They burn through a lot of energy, and it's hard to get your breath back for the warp wall, is what he needs now.
45 seconds as he approaches the warp wall, staring at a great time if he gets up.
Oh, he made it up with no problem.
Cedars takes a bow and the crowd loves it.
So that puts Dorian Cedars in the 16th position. We'll have to wait and see if his ankle affects him in the semifinals though. But that does send Sean O'Brien home, who does his own little ninja move to make his exit.